Hello and thanks for joining this tour of Sendible. My name is Dan, I'm an account executive here at Sendible and I'm going to show you around a few of the features inside the tool. A quick overview of all these tabs across the top and what you can expect to find from the tool itself. I'm going to start with the profiles because this is where you're first directed when you start a Sendible account. You can't do much until you connect your social profiles, so this is the place to do it, whether you're managing any of these sort of big four social networks, or there's YouTube as well. There's also Google My Business, and we also help you post to WordPress. So slightly different from social media being a blog, but you can connect those as well. The thing to remember when connecting these is if you're doing with LinkedIn, you've got the option of company page or personal profile. You'll need to be the admin of a company page to add it, so you'll actually log in with your personal account that is an admin of the company page. Same sort of thing with Facebook, you'll have to be the admin of the business page you're looking to add. And with Instagram, it's a little bit more complex than that, in that you have to be an admin of the Facebook page, and that Facebook page needs to be connected to the Instagram account. So I've already been in here and linked before, but if I go back, you'll see 4-inch finishing Instagram account is the one I'm trying to connect here, so I've selected that. This is a corresponding Facebook page, which the Instagram account is linked to. I'm granting permissions to both of them. Once I've done that and I leave this Facebook page, I come back to Sendible, where yeah, I've obviously connected it before, but you'll see the big connect button. And once you've done that, you're good to go. You can go ahead and start scheduling posts. So to do that, I'm going to jump to publish. This is the sort of the main calendar in Sendible where you can see all the different posts, obviously the different colors of the social networks. In the corner, you've got the initials of who scheduled the post. So DT down here, that's myself. And you can drag and drop. It makes things really quite easy to lay out your post for the week or the month. You can see posts that you've sent for approval. So I'll go into approvals in a little bit later. You can have drafts on here as well to remind yourselves of certain events and certain dates perhaps that you need to be posting about. And if I go to compose, this is where the main scheduling takes place. So you can select a bunch of different accounts. I can select multiple Facebook accounts perhaps, or I guess the most popular method would be one Facebook, one Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, that sort of thing. The only limitation there is you can't post a message to multiple Twitter accounts. They don't allow that to prevent people from sending spam, so you have to send one post at a time to Twitter, to one account at a time. Here in the original tab is where you sort of draft the main bulk of your message. So I'll write something like, check this out. I can choose a date and time as well, obviously, down here. And then you can add images and videos. So this is quite useful. You can add from your computer. You can pull from the media library, which is just anything you've used previously. On some of our plans, you have the option to integrate with Dropbox and Google Drive. On all of our plans, you have the Canva integration, which you can connect to an existing Canva account, whether it's a free version or the paid version. Under search, Google, we don't pull from Google, but you have got royalty-free images from Flickr, and we are adding pixels to this shortly, and also Giphy. So for those who like to post GIFs, you'll have those shortly. And YouTube as well on the end. I'm just going to grab this image of this car quickly. Perfect. So that's now anything I write under the original is going to be copied across all of the tabs. But you might not want your post to be exactly the same across the different social networks. In actual fact, it's telling me here on LinkedIn that this image isn't quite the right fit. If I preview the post, which you can do with the eye icon, you'll see that it's actually not far away from being a good fit, but I have these fairly ugly grey borders down the side, so we don't want that. Instead, Sendible will let you know about that. It'll ask you to, or prompt you to press this. Where we have the image formats for LinkedIn in this case saved. Same sort of thing for Instagram. That's another one where they're quite strict on the shape and size, so you'll often be doing this for Instagram. But I can go ahead and save that there, and that is now perfect size. I'm actually going to show you Instagram. I'm going to get rid of the image. I'm going to add a video instead, as Instagram. Well, all the social networks allow videos, but Instagram now also allow you to post reels. So here's a quick vertical video that I can add. Right now it's telling me that it's the wrong aspect ratio. That's because I have it selected as a regular feed post. So it's not the sort of the square shape that Instagram allows. This right here is a vertical video. But it will work as a reel. So as soon as I click that, it's going to get rid of that error message. So you've got the options there. One thing as well that you have with posting videos to Facebook and Instagram is if you click on the little pen icon, you can choose the thumbnail of the video. So it doesn't have to be the first frame. You can, this video is pretty much the same throughout the whole thing, so not maybe not the best example. But you can go ahead and just make sure that the frame is something, the first frame is something engaging perhaps, to grab your audience's attention. Cool, and yeah, that's the way you can customize. I guess as well, one thing you might use this for is to tag different people across the different social accounts. So if I type this on Facebook, it's going to give me all the possible tags on Facebook. If I go to Twitter, I've got the character count to think about as well. So that's the reason why we offer this smart posting, as we call it, just to really optimize the message depending on where it is going. When you're ready, you can go ahead and press schedule, obviously, and add that to the calendar. But I did mention I'd show you the approval process. If I press send for approval, you'll be able to, well, you have a list here of all the other users, whether that is people in your team, other people in your team, or if you are looking to work with an agency, or you're an agency and you have clients in here and you want to ask your clients for their approval, you can do. So here I have Nick at this company Full Range. I help him manage his social media. So I could say, please approve by Friday. And then Nick would receive an email, which he can obviously approve, he can reject, he can leave me some feedback. He could even send on to somebody else, perhaps, if there's another person on his end who wants to have a look. So really easy to just loop in everybody who needs to be involved and gather that feedback and make sure the post is perfect before it's actually sent to the above social networks. If I exit out of here, I'm now going to go into activity. So this is going to be all of your comments and messages. So right at the top we have, well, three Twitter here. These are all mentions of Sendible in this case. Here we are on Facebook. Someone's posted about Sendible. It looks like we've just been mentioned there at the end of the post. You'll see Instagram comments here, direct messages as well. Slightly different symbol for a direct message, the envelope icon there. So it'll all come into the single stream. You can filter it if you find that easier. But what you would then do if you're looking to engage with people is obviously like, retweet perhaps in the case of Twitter, and then reply. So reply is very similar to what we've just looked at, typing your message here, and you can still send for approval, you can still add your images, emojis, whatever else. But you obviously get an idea of what's been said before. If there has been a bit of back and forth between a few people perhaps on Twitter, it's like a thread of conversation, you want to read that before writing a response, you can do. There's also the social feeds area. So some people prefer to use this section. It breaks down your accounts individually. And also, if I look at Sendible's Twitter, I could break down messages separately from mentions. Some people prefer to do that as well, rather than having everything in the combined inbox. Bit of personal preference, really. But yeah, you've got both options there. Feel free to use whatever makes the most sense. The monitor part, I'll show you this part quickly as well. It's a little bit like the activity. It's a stream of all the mentions of a keyword. It's going to mainly be from Twitter, just because Twitter is the most open and public sort of social network out there. So it's very easy for us to listen to mentions. You could use it to listen to mentions of your competitors. You could use it to listen to mentions of your brand, perhaps. So actually Sendible. We often get mentioned in tweets, but people forget to tag us. Here's a good example. Thank you. So that's a perfect example there. That wouldn't appear in the activity part, but I can still come through here and see that someone's mentioned us. I can go ahead and reply and say thanks for the mention, or answer a query perhaps if they had a question that I need to answer. You could use it again for a bit of lead generation as well, perhaps listening to where people are asking about your services or looking for a product that you might be able to provide them with. So yeah, it can be a very useful resource. The content part, I guess, goes a bit further than just sort of social media, as these two areas do. It's more looking at news articles, so it's helping you find content ideas. That's the main reason for designing this section. So if you were in the health insurance industry, here we have all the latest articles on health insurance that you can find. If you like the look of something, you can obviously go ahead and just share that. It'll create a link preview for you, and you just choose the account you're wanting to post to. You can as well use the RSS feeds part, and I think this is often a bit more valuable just because you can refine it a little bit more. So if you already know of a blog site, maybe you have your own blog site, you can have that being pulled through here. Or if there's any publication you're aware of, if you want to set up a Google Alerts feed even, just somewhere where there's some really good content which would be useful for you to have pulled through here. Maybe it's just for your own interest, or just to kind of keep up to speed with what's happening in the industry, or if it is just content you can very quickly share and kind of bolster your social media efforts with, it can certainly be useful for that. The My Content section is a bit different. This is more of a storage area. It's like a mini Dropbox or a mini Google Drive within Sendible. It's available on some of our larger plans, and you can create as many libraries as you like. You can choose who's just a consumer of the libraries and who's actually able to contribute, which can be quite useful if you have, again, clients perhaps, and you don't want them seeing other clients' data or different departments perhaps. I've got a few ideas here of what it can be used for. Let's go for this one. So yeah, images, videos, that's I guess what most people immediately think of, but also hashtags you could store in here, regular tags. I think there are some in this library. Yep. So if you have partners, influencers you need to be tagging, they can be stored in here as well. And also it's a really good way of storing canned responses. So if you're in the activity area, which we looked at a moment ago, and somebody has asked you a question, which you get asked all the time, rather than having to type out that response again and again and again, you can just click on this book icon when responding. That's a quick link into your content library. I don't have any sort of template responses, but let's imagine this is one of them. You can just input that straight away. I haven't got to type out that response again and again. And again, if you're working as a big team, you can make sure everyone in the team is answering, I guess, in the same sort of brand voice, using the same guidelines perhaps and templates. And then we have the reporting section. So if I go to engagement, this is going to be an overall report for all of your accounts. So there's a big list there for my different accounts I manage. It's a bit of a mishmash of a few things on my end. The default date for me, I've got set to the last 2 weeks, but you are able to change that to whatever you'd like. There's a few, templates there you could use, but you can make it a custom date range if you prefer. Everything in the engagement report is fairly high level, as it's just data that has to be applicable and that kind of works and makes sense for all the social networks. So it's fairly high level, fairly basic, but it is a nice way of showing just where your traffic is, where your audience is split up, which of your posts is performing the best down here, top posts. If I go back up a little bit, you might have seen their best times to post, so that's based on previous engagements of their posts. Lots of pretty high level stats here, really good to share with managers, different departments, clients again perhaps. But then if you are looking to get into the weeds a little bit more, you can come through each social network. So Facebook, they provide us a lot more data than we can fit into the engagement one, just because some of their data wouldn't work for Twitter by nature of how the two tools are different. So it's worth coming through here, I always think, and just getting a bit more insight. So here you're seeing sort of likes in a graph, then also in a table, and then the overall percentage increase or decrease. So however you like to view your data, hopefully it's really straightforward. And if you are looking again to send it to clients or to people who maybe aren't social media experts, different departments, higher ups in the organization, you're not going to baffle them too much. It's fairly straightforward stuff. And even if there is a term they're not sure about, virality is probably the one here, which not many people will know the definition off the top of their heads. You have got the definition written there, so yeah, everyone's going to be up to speed with what's going on and what is being displayed. So similar sort of thing there for the different social networks. The Google Analytics is worth a mention. I don't know if I have any data on that account, but I can show you the PDF example report. So here you can see the number of social posts compared to visitors. Hopefully, obviously, as you post more social media, you're going to get more and more visitors to your website. You can also see how much traffic is as a result of social media, and then also out of that traffic, which social networks are doing the heavy lifting and actually driving that traffic. So yeah, I think this gives a real nice depth to the social media reports. It's not just showing you how many likes you had on an Instagram post, it is actually showing a bit more of the return on investment that you're getting. Cool, back in Sendible. We do also have this report builder down here available on some of our larger plans. Really good if you are managing multiple brands, because you can just have a different report for each one. So for my client that I manage, Full Range Finishing they're called, who I was posting to a moment ago, I can aggregate all of their data for Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and LinkedIn, rather than obviously with these ones, I have to look at each one individually. So I can aggregate it all together. I can also refine exactly what bits of data I pull through. So if I look at their Facebook page, I might want to show engagement. I might not really need to show them this stuff. They might not care about check-ins depending on what industry they're in. So it's just extra stuff that might not be of any interest to anyone. So you can really refine it a little bit more. Keep it concise, keep it engaging. So that's a real benefit there. And also you can white label these reports. So you can add your own branding to them and you can automate them to be sent out to whoever it might be, whether they're users of Sendible or not. And you can choose a frequency and have that running just in the background. So you haven't got to come in here every month or every week and rebuild the report and manually send it. It does just run itself in the background. So that part there, the final sort of customized reports, that is available on some of our higher plans. And feel free to reach out to our sales team if you did have more questions on that. Finally, I'm going to look at the user setup very briefly, because there's a few ways you could set this up. So I've mentioned agencies and managing clients through here. So if you are managing clients and you want them to have the access to be able to approve, you can set them up as client profile types. They will then only have access to their accounts, whichever accounts you share with them from here. So if I go to Nick at Full Range, you can see shared profiles just includes the Full Range accounts, obviously. Not Sendibles, not my personal stuff, no other clients, just his. Admins, they can see everything. So I'm an admin through here. If you've seen, I've jumped around quite a bit to all the different features. I can see everyone else's post as well on the calendar. And then team members, fairly transparent. They can see everyone's posts, but what they can't do that an admin can is access the subscription settings. Finally, I wanted to mention that we do have a white label as well. So if you are an agency or if you're looking to resell the features of Sendible under your own branding, here is a quick example of what a white label could look like. This is actually a co-branded one with the Buy Sendible tagline, but we can offer a full white label without this part. Again, feel free to reach out to our sales team if this might be of interest, if you are wanting to host it on your own domain as well. So your clients or your team don't have to come to sendible.com to access it, but actually something like social.yourdomain.com, whatever you decide to call that. And then we also have a resource center. So if you need some support, you can start a live chat with us through here, open a ticket with our support team. We have loads of insights on our blogs, which are social media best practices, not necessarily just related to how to use Sendible, but how to manage social media in general. Obviously there are walkthroughs of how to use Sendible and how-to guides, best practices within the tool, troubleshooting articles. If you need any more information on how to use anything, this is the place to come. And then we do have weekly webinars and walkthroughs, a bit like this. Sometimes they're more in-depth, so do keep an eye out for those. And I think that is pretty much everything for today. So thanks very much for joining me and bearing with me, running through all the features. Look forward to seeing you on a free trial if you're not already on there, and happy sending. Thanks.